Hello everyone. Today we will be covering how to use the solar and insight energy analysis for our model in FormIt. Let's begin with the dataset model from the FormIt Primer 2, to which we've added the dictionary tower dynamo object from the custom dynamo script video. Since the sun and shadows editor were covered in the sun and shadow video, in this lesson we will focus on the solar analysis tool and the use of Autodesk Insight to inform energy needs for our structures. So in the properties palette, notice that we have a location for this model which will be necessary for both solar and insight analysis, and this can be set in the set location dialog. Beginning with solar analysis, I will open the pre-made solar analysis visibility scene, which I have edited to hide all windows and objects that are unnecessary for this tool. The solar analysis does not take transparency into account, so the windows will be read as solid walls if they are selected. To start the solar analysis from the sun and shadows dropdown, click on the solar analysis button. It may take a few moments for FormIt to locate the nearest weather station and gather the required data. Now we want to select the surfaces to include in the analysis. Selecting surfaces for the solar analysis works a bit differently than regular object selection in FormIt, so it is best if you can hide all objects you do not want as part of the selection. Everything you select will be added to the selection set without holding down Shift or Control, so if you make a mistake with your selection, just deselect the elements by clicking on them again. You can also click the Reset button to clear the selection and start again. Back in the Solar Analysis Wizard, click on the Analyze button to run the analysis. This may take a minute or two, and it is normal for your FormIt canvas to go blank as the analysis begins, as it will calculate the results for each monthly peak, as well as the total annual solar loads. The result is a color spectrum for the amount of solar energy each face of all of the objects selected could produce in a cumulative year, which is being measured in kilowatt hour per square meter. Hover your mouse over any point on an analyzed face to see the radiation values at that point. Be careful not to click or it will alter your selection and you will have to rerun the analysis. Since we are set to the year cumulative range method, we are seeing the total exposures for every selected surface for the entire year. This can be useful for solar panel potential studies. With a flat roof and no tall adjacent shadow casting buildings, some of the flat roofs may be well suited to host solar panels. These calculated values, known as kilowatt hour per square meter, can be shared with a PV panel manufacturer to calculate the potential energy gains for installing PV panels all at an early stage in design. In the solar analysis wizard, change the range and method to month peak, and you are given a slider that you can adjust for each month of the year. The monthly peak mode can be useful for shading studies, and the heat gain levels are read in British thermal units, or BTUs, per square foot. It looks like the louvers on the northwest facade of the main building are doing a lot of work to block some of the late afternoon summer sun, but throughout the hotter months, the glazing of the southern street-facing sides could use some extra sun protection. If you want to export images of the study, you can press Ctrl-E or go to File, Export as Image. To exit the solar analysis, click on the small checkbox in the top left corner of the solar analysis wizard. And now that we have solar analysis down, let's jump into the insight energy analysis to derive information on the energy use that our building will require and learn about all of the different design decisions that we can make to impact it. FormIt has integrated the same building performance analysis tools that Revit uses. Insight provides a dashboard of building system parameters that can be adjusted to reflect potential scenarios without requiring you to reanalyze model geometry. Insight works best with FormIt massing geometry, so let's open the massing only scene. Since we only want to analyze the ENCODE campus and the dictionary tower, we will turn everything else off. In order to run Insight, the model must have a location applied, and you must have at least one solid object with levels applied. Now select the energy analysis icon, generate Insight. This analysis will be done in the cloud, and it may take a few minutes or more. You will know the analysis is running when your only option is to cancel, and you will know it is ready when you can select the View Insight option, which takes you to the cloud-based analysis tool in a web browser. At the top of the browser, you see a 3D model environment, and since we began with massing models, Insight has made some assumptions about the glazing on each facade, which we can change in a moment. The 3D view can be manipulated by using the toolbar to orbit, pan, zoom, walk through, edit the camera, cut a section, measure, explode the model, view all components in the model browser, change your view and performance settings, and make a view full screen. Also at the top, you can select the Add Scenarios icon and name it, and use the Compare Scenarios tool to analyze the benefits of each option against each other. As we scroll down, you will find many specific tools you can adjust to optimize your desired requirements or performance. Your building's energy impact will be summarized and updated in a single number, calculated as the bottom line cost per area. A very helpful tip, if you are new to Insight, is to select the question mark icon for a walkthrough, which will take you to each analysis tool and explain its purpose. So now let's change the model settings to get a more accurate analysis for our specific building's orientation. If you click to select the building orientation, you are given the mean energy cost and a graph of optional orientations changed by degree. If you hover over each option, you will see the readout for the potential cost savings, which can give you a quick sense if the building is worth reorienting on the site. You can drag the arrows to select a range for the overall analysis or highlight a specific angle. The BIM option will match your model. If we go to window to wall ratio for southern windows, we are given percentages of the open area to the solid. So watch if we select something small, like 15%, our energy cost mean will adjust, informing us that it is a better or worse decision. Since we gave the model a specific location, Insight knows the climate and sun angles this structure will endure. So more southern windows equals more exposure to heat gain. In roof construction, if we hover over each option, it's important to look at the cost comparisons to make sure the construction cost is worth the long-term savings. For instance, there's no difference between R15 and R19, and if I have a vast expanse of roof, that extra thickness of material could significantly add to construction costs. Insight is helpful to designers in many ways, including support for decision based on MEP systems. The HVAC analysis tool shows quite dramatically how big of a cost impact the heating and cooling approach will have on the energy cost mean for your client. Sustainability can be hard to visualize at the start of a project, and tools like these provide a tangible and easy to understand assessment that could help sway an owner to choosing more sustainably. Lastly, the photovoltaic tools can help explain savings potential if, say, your solar analysis gave you a great readout for kilowatt hour potential. Insight can break it down into real cost savings so your client can make an informed decision. As you can see, this tool is instantly helpful in designing more energy efficient buildings and understanding where energy savings and expenditures come from. These tools range from the general to the very detailed, so be sure and use it at the different stages of design to assist in decisions along the way. Insight will save your energy analysis results for future review with clients and stakeholders. If we select the Back to Insight button here on the main page, we will see our project directory, and on the right we have the model comparison of each scenario. In the Settings tab, we can change the units for measurement from imperial or metric, annual cost of energy use intensity, we can change the currency and add utility rates for more accuracy. Insight also integrated the AIA 2030 Challenge Report, so you can take your Insight model analysis and feed it directly into the AIA DDX report with no coding or configuration required. You can track an individual project as well as progress toward your firm's overall 2030 goals. You can export to Excel or connect directly to an AIA report if your firm has signed up for the commitment, which will be under your account menu, Services, and turn on AIA DDX and type in your firm and user key. That's it for FormIt Solar and Insight Energy Analysis. Be sure to check out more videos on the FormIt YouTube channel.